Hello everyone, this is Chris from Spoon Graphics. Welcome back to another video tutorial. This time we're going to play around with the Illustrator to create some retro style geometric lines and then compose them into a cool abstract poster design. So the design we'll be creating features a series of flowing striped lines that interweave and loop around each other to form an intriguing composition, which kind of reminds me of a crazy scale extract track. So start off by opening up Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. Now, because Illustrator is vector-based, the actual document size doesn't matter too much when you're just creating art, so I like to go to Window and then Hide Artboards to give me a large work area. Select the Rectangle tool and draw a long, thin rectangle on the artboard. Make sure this shape has a black fill but no stroke. Turn on Smart Guides by pressing Command and U, and then Alt and drag a duplicate of the rectangle so it butts up against the original. Hold down the shortcut keys Command and D to form a series of aligned rectangles. Activate the selection tool, then hold down the Shift key while clicking every alternative rectangle, then give these shapes a white fill to create a striped pattern. Now if your white stripes end with a white rectangle, go ahead and delete it so there's a black rectangle at each end. Drag a selection around all these rectangle shapes, then under the Brushes panel, click the New Brush icon. Select the new art brush option, then hit OK. In the brush settings, make sure the direction option runs along the flow of the striped pattern, then press OK to create the brush. Select the line tool and draw a short line on the artboard while holding shift to keep it straight. Make sure this path has no fill, then click the new brush from the brushes panel to apply the striped effect. Now try lengthening this line with the selection tool, and if your stripe gets larger instead of just getting longer, you might need to configure your Illustrator settings. Go to Illustrator, Preferences and then General, then uncheck the Scale Strokes and Effects setting. The striped pattern will now remain the same size regardless of the path length. Grab the Ellipse tool and hold Shift to draw a circle, then select our brush from the Brushes panel to apply the striped pattern. Duplicate this circle a couple of times by holding Alt while dragging the shape, then activate the Direct Selection tool and delete a single point from the first circle. This will leave you with a half circle. On the next circle, delete two points to form a quarter circle. Then next on the final circle, select the Scissors tool from under the Eraser tool menu, then clip the path between two of the points. Select and delete this point using the Direct Selection tool to form a three-quarter circle. We can now start building a design using these ready-made components, so hold the Alt key and drag out a copy of the three-quarter circle. Next, make a copy of the line segment and use the Smart Guides to accurately line up the endpoint so the pattern flows continuously. Drag out another three-quarter circle, but this time rotate it so the start and end points finish in different directions and align it to the end of the last piece. Use another line tool to continue the flow of the pattern, but this time rotate it by 90 degrees, remembering to hold the Shift key to restrict the angles. So just the layering of the elements, use the shortcuts Command and the square bracket keys, or right click and under the Arrange menu select Send Backwards. This allows you to loop and weave the path as it flows around the artboard. Continue extending the design with additional pieces, creating interesting compositions as it expands in size, but keep in mind the rough proportions of your final poster size. Once your design's almost complete, the two end pieces can be finished by either extending them so they'll be completely cropped off the edge of the poster, or loop them back underneath one of the existing paths. Once the line's pattern is complete, we'll switch over to Photoshop to add some finishing touches. We could add the texture in Illustrator, but Photoshop's much more powerful when it comes to creating aged effects. Find an old paper texture just like the one I'm using that can be found in the description and paste it into your Photoshop poster document. Go to Image, Adjustments and Desaturate to take out all the colour. Next, go to Image, Adjustments and Levels and alter the contrast of the texture by dragging the shadow slider inwards slightly. Next, bring out the details of the paper texture by going to Filter, Sharpen and selecting Sharpen. Copy the line pattern from Illustrator and paste it into the Photoshop document. Scale it to size to fit the canvas before applying the changes with the Enter key. Next, download and open one of my free Dust and Scratches textures, link to which can be found down in the description, then press Select All and copy it to the clipboard. Switch back to the main working document, then add a layer mask to the lines layer. Hold the Alt key and then click on the layer mask thumbnail in the layers panel to enter into the mask editing mode. Paste in the dust and scratches texture that you copied earlier, then press Command and I to invert it to black on white. Press Command and L to open up the levels adjustment and darken the blacks by moving the shadow slider inwards to increase the contrast. Click anywhere to exit out of the layer mask editing mode to see the distressed texturing applied to the lines artwork. Next, create a new layer, then select a large soft brush and randomly dab a few spots of white across the artboard. Reduce the opacity of this layer to around 30% just to add some subtle changes in tone. Subtle effects like this aren't very noticeable, but if you turn the layer off, you can see how much of a difference they actually make. So there we have our finished retro style geometric lines artwork. Illustrator's brush tool and vector editing abilities made it easy to build up the composition, and then Photoshop did a great job of adding those extra details to distress and age the design. So if you enjoyed this video tutorial, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up to help spread the word. You can also subscribe on YouTube to be the first to check out my future video uploads. Don't forget to also stop by at my Spoon Graphics website if you want to see more tutorials just like this, and subscribe to my mailing list to receive notifications of new content as well as my free resources bundle. So thanks for taking the time to watch. I hope you enjoy making use of this retro lines effect, and I'll catch you all later.